Hi friends, today we are going to learn very easy chapter. I will tell you the name of chapter: Physical and Chemical Energy. Physical and chemical changes. And in this chapter, we are going to learn a lot of things. First of all, we'll learn what is the definition of physical changes and chemical changes. Then we will go for the differences between physical and chemical changes. Then we go for some chemical reactions, and we will understand the example. What are the basic fact and what are the basic points by why physical changes happened and why chemical changes happened, and how we can identify the physical changes and how we can identify the chemical changes. So take out your notebook, because this is important for you to jot down the definition, because this definition is very unique and very impressive for you. So take out your notes so that you can, while writing, you can understand what is the basic fact of physical changes. A change in which no new substances are formed and which can generally be reversed by reversing the conditions is called a physical change. You can note down, I'll repeat it again. A change in which no new substances are formed and which can generally be reversed by reversing the condition is called a physical change. Let me explain what exactly it is. See, we are living in a place where we used to see lot of things in daily life. Like you are taking fruits, when fruits used to be in a very raw position, after some days it gets ripe. The color used to be changed. Earlier, suppose you are taking mango, earlier it used to be green, and after some time it becomes yellow. When we are using ice, when we are taking ice from freeze, we are putting in a plate, it becomes liquid. Like we are taking milk and we are preparing curd by milk. So if you start your daily routine 24 hours, you will observe that so many changes happening in our daily life. So many changes happening. Like you see that barf used to become liquid, then gas, then again it becomes ice. Then melting of wax, like when we are burning the mombatti, then you will come to know that it burns and wax used to be melt, and after that it get melted and again we can prepare mombatti. So many things are here in our day-to-day life. Or I will tell you one another exercise also, by which you can identify in your surroundings, in your house, in-house even, or in family, that you can identify. You can prepare a chart where you can identify what are the changes in physical and what are the changes in chemical. This is very important for us to understand the basic point for physical changes and chemical changes. But first of all, we have to understand what is physical changes, and the definition and the explanation is very simple. The changes where no new substances, again I am going to repeat the word, it is very important, no new substances. Whenever the changes comes, you will not get any new substances, and generally be reversed by reversing. This is also very important word, reversed by reversing the condition is called a physical change. Somewhere you see the changes happen, somewhere you see the changes happen, any physical changes happen, and it get reversed also. Means when the changes is a start, it start and go to end, and again it come back on the first phase. Like suppose I'm giving you some examples, and I'll explain you the examples also. Like melting of wax. In case of melting of wax, when we are using mombatti, then after burning, the thread used to be lost the thread, and the wax used to be melted. And when we are taking the wax in a bowl, again you have to prepare the mombatti. Second is grinding of a substance. See, I tell you, grinding of a substance. This meaning is itself, when you are taking 2 spoons of sugar. When you take 2 spoons of sugar, you have to start melt in a glass of water and you have to go for heating. After heating, the water will be evaporated and only you will get a sugar part. So this is also a process where it satisfies the physical changes. Formation of clouds. In case of formation of clouds, what happened? The water used to be get heated, it becomes the cloud, and cloud is to be get again comes in a phase of water. A stretching of rubber. This is a very good example for physical changes. A stretching of a rubber. A stretching of a rubber. Everyone having a in house, you are having a rubber. Just take it rubber and put it in your hand and just stretch it. Once you stretch it and you leave it, again it will come on a original position. Like I tell you how it happened. See, this is the size of rubber. You are taking your house. You start stretching this. Once you start stretching it towards this and toward this, the size used to be bigger. And the moment you leave, it again comes on its original position. You can identify this is the first position. After stretching, this becomes the second position. And again you leave, then it becomes first position. So this is a very unique changes happen and it again come on the first position. The same thing in so many examples are here. I'm giving you only four examples. But if you go through this, you will come to know so many examples are for the physical changes. Right? So many examples are there for physical changes. But these are the unique examples by which you can understand the physical changes. Now we come on chemical changes. Please write down this definition. See, I made this both the explanation and definition in such a way where you can understand and you can learn very well what is the major difference in this. See, this is chemical change and this is physical change. If you go through the definition, you will come to know here no new substances and here new substances. This is a major difference you will feel between physical and chemical changes. In chemical changes, new substances. Whenever the chemical changes comes, you will get a new substances. And are formed. And see, this is a very important word. Which cannot be reversed. Once the chemical, please note down both the definitions. These are very important. If you go through the definition, then only you can understand what is the meaning of physical and what is the chemical change. And very carefully you have to go through the definition. Here you will feel, here you come to know that no new substances and here new substances. In chemical, these are the major changes. In chemical change, you will come to know always new substances. Right? And it cannot be reversed. Like suppose, a stretching of a rubber band. Where you are stretching the rubber and again this comes on a right place. But in this chemical change, once the substance becomes, it cannot back on a first place. So I am telling you two major and three major points are there. We will go through the same after finishing the same. Like suppose physical changes, if you want to know the differences. In physical changes, no new substances comes, or in chemical changes, new substances come. Right? And second, no reverse means once the chemical changes had happened, no reverse process comes. Like a stretching of rubber, it cannot come back. Now we come on the example and I'm going to explain you the chemical change with the help of the example. See, storing of milk. We are taking milk. Once we are taking the milk in our house, we are putting milk in a bowl or we are preparing curd. Once you prepare the curd, you cannot get the milk by curd. This is the first example. Second is ripping of fruits. Once the fruit get ripped up, it cannot come back on his position. Photosynthesis. Everyone is knowing this process. You have already learned in class 6 or class 5 photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is a catabolic process under which plant used to prepare the food for them. Once the plant prepared the food by the help of soil and sun ray, the plant cannot back the sun ray or back the water, back the soil to the first primary stage. Burning of any substance, if you take a piece of paper, if you burn the paper, if you are taking piece of paper or anything, whatever you want to take and you burn it, after burning, any substance after burning, it cannot come on a first position. Let me explain you again. See, if you are taking anything and you get it burned, right? If you get it burned, like it's a piece of paper. Once it get burned, it becomes black ash, right? And if you want to get it again, piece of paper, it's not possible. We are having so many examples for the chemical changes. Like suppose I tell you, digestion of food. In case of digestion of food, what happened? Once food gets digested, it cannot back on a first position. Like boiling of rice. Once rice gets boiled, it cannot come on a right position. I tell you, you can do one exercise at your home. This is my suggestions. Or you can do it at home. Then you can understand very well what are the major changes and what are the things are being changed at home. See, you can prepare a chart. You can prepare a chart like this. One side you write physical change and another side you write chemical change. One second. You prepare a chart at home. Take a white paper. You write physical and chemical, and you write point number one. Like suppose once you got up early in the morning, you just watch in your house, in your surroundings or in family, day to day basis housekeeping, whatever work is going on, like cooking, like washing, you are eating the food, like you are in a garden, you are drinking water, whatever you are doing, whatever job you are doing, you divide it in a physical and chemical changes. Automatically you will understand. See, we have learned here, in physical changes we will not get any new substance. In a chemical we are getting new substance. Physical, it can be reversed by reversing process. In a chemical, it cannot be reversed. So this exercise you can do at home. Now few are the basic points by which we can understand what are the basic difference between physical and chemical changes. Because these are very important points. These are very important point. One side I am writing physical change and another side chemical change. What are the major point to understand? See, physical change always it is temporary, right? And chemical change is permanent, right? Or reversible. This is always reversible. This one is irreversible. And the third one is no new substance. And here you will get new substance. So these are the major difference between physical and chemical changes.
See, I tell you, once you prepared a chart, physical or chemical changes at your home, this is a very good exercise. And I tell you, everyone has to focus on this, because this is very simple chapter, but only you have to understand. And you can raise your doubt to me on comments, or I will be assessed on my WhatsApp number also. This number you will get very soon. So physical and chemical changes, prepare a chart in your house, and you identify what are the job work, what are the work, what are the things what we are doing in our daily life, what are in physical and chemical. And you have to only you have to watch. Physical changes is what? Temporary. Temporary is a word where you come to understand, hey, this is not having a life. And permanent, once the changes had happened in chemical changes, it is permanent, means it is having a long life. Then reversible, I already explained you. Like suppose I tell you, for reversible, I am giving a very suitable example for ice cube. See, these are the ice cube. You take in a dish. You can take aluminium dish, maybe you are having in your house, and put it on flame, right? In laboratory we are using burner, but at home you can have on gas stove. The ice get melted and it converted in liquid, right? Afterward it becomes gas, in form of gas. And when we are putting any dish here, it again converted in liquid. And if you put this liquid in freeze, it becomes ice. It's a very simple process and method and experiment which you can do at home. You take some piece of cube from freeze on any utensils in your home and get it heated, but you put some utensils on this so that because of the evaporation process it melted and it becomes liquid. And after liquid becomes gas, then again gas converted in liquid, and liquid has to convert it in it, after freezing it becomes ice. So what we learn here, this is the process. Ice get converted in liquid, liquid get converted in gas, or again this gas is converted in liquid and it converted in ice. Suppose ice is a first phase, liquid is a second phase, and gas is third phase, but this is gas become liquid, liquid become ice. So this is a very good example for physical change, and this is very important to understand this process. So many processes are there, but you can go through the same. Got the point? These are the major changes in physical and chemical changes. First point is temporary changes, second is permanent, second is reversible. This is irreversible, yani once change had happened, it cannot come back. And then in physical changes, no new substances is being performed. Or in chemical changes, always you get a new substance. And this is a very suitable examples. Okay? I hope you do this exercise at home on a daily routine to understand what are the things has been done on a daily life. What is the physical change and what is the chemical change? So today we have learned what is physical changes and what is chemical changes as per our 7th class chapter, and this is our first chapter. Now we have to go for some chemical symbolic form. See, I tell you some abbreviations are there, and let me explain you some see, there are symbols and formulas. Because physical changes are no having longer positioning and points to understand or further, but chemical changes are very important for us. So some other symbolic formulas I tell you, like hydrogen, this indicates H. Carbon, C. Nitrogen, N. Oxygen, O. Sodium, Na. Iron, Fe. Sulfur, S. These are the symbols by which these are the chemical substance by which we can understand the symbols of the same. So many are there in your book. You go through the same, because we need to know the short form of these symbols. Cobalt, CO. Chlorine, Cl. Bromine, Br. Cu. At least you go through this and see. I read you. Hydrogen, H. Carbon, C. Nitrogen, N. Oxygen, O. Copper, Cu. Sodium, Na. Iron, Fe. Sulfur, S. Cobalt, CO. Chlorine, Cl. Bromine, Br. Okay. So you go through whatever the books you are having, you will see the these are the symbols you will find, and go through the same, because it's required, because in next lecture we are going to learn about the chemical reactions which is happening around us. Thank you. Have a good day.